Hello.
Hi, Miriam. Nice to see you and hear you. I'm calling you because I heard that on iBelong project, you were working on developing interesting manual, community mentoring manual. So what this document offers?
Well, we did develop the community mentoring manual as part of the iBelong project. And the manual provides a guideline of how to implement mentoring programs, like in our case, the community mentoring programs, not only in theory, but also really practically and concrete about how exactly can I implement this mentoring at my institution.
And what's your favorite feature of it? As a student, mentor, and a teacher, what would be your favorite part of it?
Well, I think there's a lot of great parts of it. In fact, I'm a very practical researcher. And when I look for something I can use for my projects, for example, in the internet, I always try to find something that I can use directly. Not some concepts only, but also something that I can really just copy paste or just use and print out for myself and then use it directly. And I think the community manual really provides a lot of these parts, like tools, templates, guidelines, and direct printouts that you can just use. And I really enjoy that part.
Yeah, I was really impressed when I saw your document. So I could see how, you're welcome. You really worked hard on it. Let me ask you, do you think it's more for mentors or it's also for mentees? Can mentees also use it or it's more kind of guidelines for mentors?
Well, basically it's for the ones who want to start a mentoring program. So it's more for the institutional part. And in there, mentors might find, for example, training parts or something, things they can use with mentees, for example. But the general idea is that it's used by institutional or project owners who want to develop a mentoring program.
And did you find anything similar online before? Did you use anything similar or you think there is something novel here?
I think the novel part here might be that it's very practical and like has a nice user-friendly design, and it's still based on scientific researches because we evaluated everything we did, and we have a huge expertise in mentoring and as generally. And so I think the novel part might be that it's from science for the practical implementation. So in this transfer, I feel like it's a very novel step to take.
And my last question, how do you think this can improve the institutional culture?
I feel like mentoring is not something new. So most institutions do have mentoring programs or do have programs that are similar to this. And the question is not only how to make a totally new program, but also to have something that can improve already existing mentoring programs. And that can also be used as like modularly. I can't really say that word. So you can only have like parts from it. You can take things. You can have adaptive parts of it. If you already have a mentoring program, you can still read it and use parts of it just to improve your own program. So it's not only this is the way and there's no other way, but it's also like take everything that you like from it and that's it.
Thank you. I think that now everybody can understand how to use it and how to benefit from it. Thank you for this short call. Bye.
Don't worry. Thanks a lot. Ciao,
Ivana. Ciao, ciao.